Guys, you're not gonna believe what I found. Holy crap. When did she go to Kuwait again? Is this a post that Foodie put? I'm not Muslim, nor have I ever observed the faith, so I'm sorry if these aren't the best sources or if they have some unsavory content. All religions can be strong in their own opinions. I swear, I just came across this and I'm it's like it's meant to be. Probably a real or foodie beauty. Probably real foodie beauty. Oh, wow. I was just trying to. Yeah, it's good. Is gluttony a sign of sin? And lo and behold, Reddit our foodie beauty. Is obesity frowned upon in Islam? Let's take a look, see. The causes of problematic and overeating and lack of physical are all prohibited or discouraged in, I apologize, in Islam. I apologize again. Everyday Miriam. Stuffing her face. 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 Big huge bread bowl. Stuffing her face. Is obesity frowned upon? In Islam, the causes of I am so sorry. The causes of obesity are problematic in Islam. Overeating, eating unhealthy food, lack of physical activity, laziness, wastefulness are all prohibited or discouraged in Islam. Let's watch this video, The Truth About Ramadan.
Well, it's that time of year again. And as you can see, I'm fasting, Islam style. When most people think of fasting, they think of not eating. They think of abstaining from food. But in Islam, aka opposite world, fasting means gorging yourself with food multiple times per day. I guess you could say that Muhammad's followers are abstaining, in a weird sense, during Ramadan. They're abstaining from not gorging themselves with endless piles of delicious food. Islamic fasting is what we would ordinarily call feasting. For comparison, the closest thing non-Muslims have to Ramadan in the U.S. is Thanksgiving dinner. That's our big meal of the year. But yes, Ramadan goes on for a month, and they have two gigantic meals per day. Imagine having two Thanksgiving dinners per day, every day, for an entire month. Pretty gross, right? Pure gluttony. Now imagine having two Thanksgiving dinners per day, every day, for an entire month, and calling it fasting. Imagine gorging yourself with food until you almost pass out multiple times per day, over and over again, day after day, while you announce to the world, "See how devout I am? I'm fasting." Strange use of the word fasting, isn't it? Alright, now what? Ooh. Gordita. Ramadan fasting is what we might call trans fasting. It's feasting that identifies as fasting. As such, our Muslim friends are to be accorded all the rights and privileges of the LGBTQ community, which means that the rest of us have to agree with them that shoveling giant plates of food into their mouths is, indeed, fasting. Milk. See how easy it is to call something by a completely different name from what it actually is? If you're new to the fast of Ramadan, hope I don't get canceled for that slip. If you're new to the fast of Ramadan, here's a brief introduction. Ramadan fasting is one of the five pillars of Islam, the most essential practices of the religion. Ramadan is the ninth month of the Islamic lunar calendar. Muslims who aren't exempt for some reason are required to abstain from food, beverages, and sexual intercourse from dawn to sunset for the entire month. But once the sun goes down, it's party time. How this works in practice is quite telling. In practice, many Muslims simply reverse their day-night sleeping schedule. They sleep during the day and stay up eating all night, with special emphasis on two huge meals, one after sunset and one before sunrise. So, in practice, Muslims who are fasting get together and gorge themselves with food at night, then gorge themselves with food early in the morning, then sleep all day. They wake up in the evening after a long day of sleeping and gorge themselves with food again.
Once again, how Foodie is getting around fasting all day. How she's not eating all day because she changes her sleep schedule.
Then they snack all night and gorge themselves again early in the morning and again sleep all day. They repeat this cycle for an entire month. One of the main reasons I think it's utterly ridiculous to call this month-long cycle of binge eating and sleeping fasting is that my ordinary everyday schedule would almost qualify as Islamic fasting, minus the binge eating and the endless terrorist attacks we call the Ramadan Bombathon. As many of you know, I have five sons. Two of them have been on life support their entire lives. They have a rare genetic muscle disease. I'm done eating before sunrise. Sleep is every night. I sleep during the day. My last meal before I go to sleep is around 5 a.m. So, I'm done eating before sunrise. I go to sleep around 7 or 8 in the morning. I wake up around 3 or 4 in the afternoon. My first meal of the day is around 5 or 6 o'clock in the evening. True, that's a little before sundown right now, but it would be very, very easy for me to shift my schedule slightly so that I only eat breakfast after sundown. Now, if I were to shift my schedule slightly, eating my first meal after sundown and eating my last meal before sunrise, can anyone say with a straight face that I would be fasting? According to Islam, I'm almost fasting all year long. Should I go around bragging about what a devout religious person I am because of all the fasting I do? Do you have any idea how insane that sounds? Think about it. Lots of people around the world, and lots of people down through history, eat their last meal of the day around 6 or 7 p.m. They eat breakfast around 6 or 7 a.m. Would anyone say that all these people are fasting because they go 12 hours without eating? Of course not. Well, what if they suddenly get night jobs and reverse their schedules? Is it fasting then? According to Islam, yes, it's fasting. Wow, that is a delicious chicken sandwich. Ah! It's Chick-fil-A. It's a Christian chicken sandwich. On behalf of cultural critics everywhere, I would like to issue this heartfelt apology to the trans fasting community for hurting their religious feelings by devouring a delicious Christian chicken sandwich during the month of Ramadan. Sorry, Ramadan. I gotta have some of these waffle fries, though. I call them fasting fries. If I got paid for product placement, I could buy Twitter from Elon. This is bad. I'm stuffed. How do they keep this up for an entire month? I need to go purge. All right, I'm back and ready for Ramadan round two. According to scholars, Ramadan is Arabic for eating disorder. Vimto is now like the official drink of
Don't mind
Ramadan.
him.
It's pure sugar.
He's
I
just
think
a
Vimto
fizzer.
is the Arabic word for diabetes.
Once again, Vimto does support Israel.
Tastes like carbonated cherry pancake syrup. You may be wondering, David, why do you care about this trans fasting? If people who are gorging themselves with food want to identify as fasting, who are you to judge? Well, there are two main reasons I'm talking about this. One, Ramadan is destroying Muslims physically. And two, Ramadan is destroying Muslims spiritually. First, the physical. We don't need a prophet to tell us that filling your belly with horribly unhealthy food multiple times per day for an entire month every year is bad for you. There's a sharp rise in hospital visits during Ramadan, many of them due to digestive problems. There's a surge in uncontrolled diabetes cases because of Ramadan. Thanks to Ramadan, obesity is on the rise in Muslim countries. Gulf countries.
Holy crap, Chantal. You know what? I think you, according to this, I think you're a pretty good, damn good Muslim. You've been practicing for years. I mean, didn't you go to the hospital for eating an entire block of cheese in one night? You good shit to save your breath, to save yourself. I apologize. I think you're a great Muslim.
Countries are now among the fattest countries in the world. But as long as they don't eat pork, it's all halal,
What
am I
was
right?
that? What was that? A cultural shift to take away food is easily noticeable in Kuwait. Girl, you have been making your rounds. Ooh. Ah, see? No, Chantal, you are a great Muslim.
In the
You are.
world. But as long as they don't eat pork, it's all halal, am I right? Food retailers have to start stocking up at least a month before Ramadan in order to keep up with the increase in food sales. Food bills increase by 50 to 100% during the month of fasting. And depending on the area, food bills can increase much more. Medical journals still find this confusing. They say things like, "Surprisingly, weight gain and not weight loss was reported after Ramadan by Saudis, which indicates
I'm as shocked as you are, Dr. Woods.
timely needed lifestyle and dietary modification programs for a population which reports one of the highest prevalence rates of diabetes." Yes, shocker. A month of binge eating every year leads to health problems. There are tons of studies reporting these kinds of issues, and when you point out what Ramadan is doing to the Muslim community, Muslims reply, "But we don't all do that." Okay, there may be exceptions, but the statistics show this is a massive problem everywhere Islam goes. But it gets worse. Keep in mind that not everyone who's trans fasting can sleep all day. Some people have to go to work during the day after partying all night, but then they can't even have a sip of water.
So, Foodie, why don't you get a job? I mean, you totally live in Kuwait. You totally You don't do visa runs. I mean, you totally live there. Get a job. Get a nice job.
While they're working, leading to a range of medical emergencies, heat stress, traffic accidents, and so on. But as long as they don't drink a beer, it's all halal, am I right? Productivity drops between 35 and 50% during Ramadan. Imagine being less productive while giving yourself diabetes and going into debt to pay for all the food you're shoving down your gullet. What a religion. Islam? More like morbidly obese-lam. So, Ramadan causes lots of health problems for trans-fasting Muslims. But that's just the physical. There's also the spiritual. Muslims claim that they follow Jesus. They say, we follow Jesus more than you Christians. Now, what they really mean when they say this is that they follow what Muhammad said about Jesus. They claim to follow all the prophets, but they're just following what one false prophet said about all the prophets. So at the end of the day, they're still following one false prophet and no one else. They definitely don't follow the Lord Jesus Christ, who was the all...
Yeah, I know, this is... What, what are you talking about? We'll talk about the Lord in another time. But, yeah, so, Chantel, Miriam, I gotta apologize. No, you are excellent. Well, I'd say you are the queen of Ramadan, I gotta admit.
Thanks for all that, Hamel.
I don't want to see the garbage.
Okay. Really, Crystal? It's very peaceful. I know, like, hearing the Quran recited, it, I know it does that. It gives you chills. Like, there's a video of, like, a guy reciting a Quran around, like, a pasture of animals, and they all come to him. It's so weird. Kind of making a big deal how you cut your chicken, right? Like, somebody who sleeps with a child predator or a sex offender makes fun of how I cut, like, okay, I'll recreate it, no problem. You know what? I'm on Thursday, I can't drink. I didn't even have to cut the chicken. Like, whenever you simmer a chicken for long enough, hi Ava, thank you, it falls apart. So I literally only had to tear it apart. Like, basically it actually just fell off. Like the spine, everything just fell off basically. And then I roasted it in the oven. It's a very common way of cooking. Like, again, people are just ignorant. Like, recreate it yourself. Simmer the chicken for long enough, it will come right off the bone. You don't have to cut it. Like, there's no, I know, I can't with these people. I can't. It's food all going to the same place. Like, what's the conspiracy about? Like, I don't get it. Like, people are so bored, have no content. It's really embarrassing. Are you not embarrassed or what? I know.
Oh, Chantel, you're the content that keeps on giving. I mean, you run your mouth and we all have reactions. I mean, it's one of the best things of the day.
Teardrop. It does that in the crock pot, yeah, Crystal, but I don't have a crock pot. So I slow cook in a big pot, you know? Ava, it's so stupid. I know, Krista. Hey, Krista. Hey, Pink Pony Club. Amy, hello. I'm honestly just so over this person, this trash bag of a human, just coming for me and my religion and how I practice and every little thing I do, like, to the point where, like, I swear, if somebody bought me a plane ticket today, I would go next week to Canada just to sue the crappy, stale leggings off of them. I would, 100%. I know.
What is Frenchie doing wrong now? She's not doing anything wrong. How can you sue her? Does Canada have freedom of speech? Oh, Chantal? Oh. The Canadian Charter of Rights and Freedoms is the equivalent to our Bill of Rights. Both guarantee the right to freedom of speech and the press peaceably assemble, travel, due process, privacy, and attorney and speech trial in criminal cases and trial by jury in certain cases. Does Canada limit freedom of speech? Oh. No, Chantal, you can't. If she, You can't go and sue Frenchie because you don't like what she says. No! No, maybe in Kuwait, but you can't do anything to Frenchie. I'm so sorry. But then your motherland, you can't sue for that. Oh. Get over it.
Uh-oh, Big Dot. That doesn't sound pleasant at all. Oh, no. I've been taking omeprazole, like, because I've been taking a lot of, like, anti-inflammatories, which I haven't actually taken any, like, today yet. Well, I can't really, I guess. So.
Omeprazole. It's not for anti-inflammatory. Omeprazole is for a shit, rank, skank, nasty, bitch-ass stomach. It's supposed to lower the stomach acids.
But, like, I'm gonna...
Who's got a sick tummy?
Bit of pain, but, I took omeprazole last night, and, like, I don't know, it's so, like, it feels so weird in my stomach.
Probably didn't catch on, you're supposed to take that. It's good to take omeprazole on an empty stomach, because if you have too much stomach acid, it's going to eat it just as if you put boric acid on a pill. It's going to eat it right up before it even touches your esophagus.
Yeah, it's kind of warm. I have the AC turned all the way down.
Oh!
To my stomach, yeah. I don't know if it's like to protect my stomach from, like, you know, taking anti-inflammatory. I have to, like, cut down on them, actually, so I don't know.
Ah!
Vanessa with the emojis.
Yeah. Yeah.
I'm afraid, like, to always have something in my teeth, but...
See, she, yeah. So, yeah, it is, it's anti-inflammatory for you. It's omeprazole, once again. Omeprazole. Yeah. Mm-hmm. So her stomach is beating the shit out of her. It's not an anti-inflammatory. It helps reduce the stomach acid. She's just eating and eating and eating and eating and eating and eating and eating. Eat, eat, eat. Eat, eat, eat. Little. Shirley. Season. Let's see.
I got beans, greens, potatoes, tomatoes, lamb, ram, raw, beans, greens, potatoes, tomatoes, chicken, turkeys, rat.
You mean?
Beans, greens, potatoes, tomatoes, lamb, ram, raw, raw, beans, greens, potatoes, tomatoes, chicken, turkeys, chicken, turkeys, beans, greens, potatoes, tomatoes, lamb, ram, raw, raw. Beans, greens, potatoes, tomatoes, beans, greens, potatoes, tomatoes, beans, greens, potatoes, greens, beans, 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 beans.
Yeah, you can torch with this.
Chicken, 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 beans, greens, potatoes, tomatoes, chicken, chicken.
And that leads to needing yeah.
I know I don't. I brush them. The beach looks incredibly beautiful. Yeah, it really is. But I'm, like, nervous because the summer's coming. And I always forget how, like, see if I don't wear an undercap under my hijab, it, like, slips down all the time. Oh, so annoying. If it weren't so hot, yeah. It's very, very hot. Like, more than you can imagine. My mouth is dry.
Slips down.
I don't know how people like go to work and school and
put
this like frosting like this.
Take those fucking curtains down and make it a hijab and maybe it'll fit.
I don't know. It's crazy. You know. What bothers me is how often they repeat the same stuff. Yeah. Like, talk about beating a dead horse over and over and over. Like, that just proves to you that they need my crappy content. If I have no content, then what do you have? Your
crappy content is hysterical. Everyone needs a good laugh, and you deliver. Like DoorDash that you order.
Content is literally picking at how I cut my chicken, or how I'm praying in the wrong direction when that's not even true. So you're literally inventing lies just to keep your hate-hungry audience eating something because they have nothing. Nothing, zilch, no life. And these are adults. Or imagine just beating today.
Well, what I'm laughing, what we're all laughing at is how you're some goddess at the stove. You burn the shit out of your food, or you don't cook it enough, and everyone in the house is getting typhoid. I mean, we need this. We need a good laugh. It's like Woodstock. It brings people together, Chantal.
Imagine what kind of a mother is raising a child fat.
No. You didn't want yours, Chantal. And I'm gonna leave it at that. Could have been a mother. Hate me? Hate me. Don't be bashing mothers. Nope. Once again, the scale's going down, the scale's tipping. You're being a bad girl. You're not supposed to be nasty like that.
Another woman on the internet. You can see roles in your bio. And what's your point? I'm fat. Does it look like I care? what kind of person like just sits there and body shames somebody for content? Bye, runaway. Thank you.
Because it's a joke. Because you're fucking up the scale. You're pretending to be 335 pounds when you were 375 pounds when you were living with BB. Let's not play this bullshit these bullshit games. You aren't fat. You're humongous. You filter everything out. And, you're fat.
Teardrop. Yes. I was so worried about him. Oh, but he's okay.
And it's a shame that for 5 minutes you cannot put your fucking fork down. That's the shame.
Thank you, Teardrop. They want to get you going. Well, yeah, fine. I'll speak out about their lies and their hypocrisy and their Islamophobia then.
Actually, I'm not afraid of you. Phobia! Phobia, phobia, phobia. Oh, phobia. Definition. An extreme or irrational fear of or aversion to something. I don't fear you, girl. I don't fear you.
When he comes over, Crystal. That's okay. I mean, you don't know. You know, you forget. Not to even drink in front of him. I think that's the hardest part, is like the no water thing. For sure. But alhamdulillah, it's possible. It's not like horrible, you know. It's not like it's like 24 hours, you know. It's just from sunrise to sundown, whatever. You can like super chats. Hi, Superman. Doesn't chicken kind of fall apart in the same places when it's cooked? How they were both legs were even. It's not like I up close, like next time I'll up close the skin to show you the skin placement. In some places it was curled up a little bit. Oh god, I'm sorry.
Ew, nasty skink attitude. Chicken didn't look, it didn't look right. I don't know. I know how to cook chicken, my mom knows how to cook chicken, my family knows how to cook chicken. I'm just saying.
You just can't swallow the water, Gracie, but you can brush your teeth. Yeah. Yeah, like, you can brush your teeth and rinse, but just don't swallow water. So. Sometimes if my mouth gets really dry, I just put a bit of water and spit. So. I'm sad that I guess I didn't have to do this, but yes, I did. Because if you're gonna lie about me and how my religion, like, too bad for you. I would never make it through Ramadan. You wouldn't be exempt here, Draw, because you have, you know, illnesses and stuff. And I do too. Technically, I don't have to fast. Like, if I ever feel very, very unwell, or not, like, if I need.
Oh, let's see. Do people with diabetes need to fast for Ramadan? Okay, there are exceptions to this. One of them is that people who are ill or have medical conditions do not have to fast. This can include people living with diabetes. Okay, back to the video.
Needed to, then I would, yeah, but that's between me and Allah. You know, I'm not gonna like talk about it on live, and I'm not gonna like announce it publicly, but
Saint Chantal, still fasting with the diabetes.
So far, so good. Alhamdulillah.
Alhamdulillah.
Because she has no brain. Like, this is not just shaming her. It's legit. She has very low intelligence to be able to not realize certain things. Like people don't... People who are intelligent and have a life, they don't sit there and discuss dumb, weird, petty things and pick apart the life of somebody else and, like, make up lies and attack religions and, like... discuss religions during Ramadan, how Muslims are worshiping when you're not even Muslim, or comparing a Muslim to another person. I saw another lowlife do that, comparing, oh, well, we're going to compare her, how she does her vlogs and worships and all this other stuff, how she does her vlogs during Ramadan. Look, the point of Ramadan is not to be fancy and how many fancy abayas you can afford to wear. Maybe that person has more money than us. Like, what are you doing? Like, shaming someone's finances now? Like, maybe that person has a different lifestyle. Like, I'm not all about that. I don't care. I'm not going to waste all my money on trinkets when I can give it to the poor, which is what the spirit of Ramadan is about. It's about zakat.
Girl, you don't give to the poor. The poor give to you. Next time you go to the grocery store, Chantal, bring home the receipt. So we know that you didn't pay $5 to a food bank and they just gave you a shit ton of food.
And donating and praying. It's not about...
And why don't you go ahead and... do what you said you were going to do. You said you were going to give that woman money. You never did. A nurse accidentally gave you $300 once. Mine now.
How many fancy decorations you can put in your apartment. Like, people who know nothing have the most to say.
If your house was the Taj Mahal, I think you would have went all out. Okay.
Crystal, the water's bad there in Mexico. Hi, backwards, babe.
Yes. The water in Mexico is horrendous. One swallow and you'd probably send you to the hospital if you were not from Mexico.
Yeah. I never knew anything about Ramadan until this channel, but it's interesting to learn. Yeah, well, that's okay. I mean, I'm trying my best. Like, I mean, that's great, Eva, but I'm new to this too. Like, you know, like, I know it's like my second year, but still, like, compared to somebody who was born and raised and taught Islam in school, like, I was raised Catholic, you know? So I took, like, catechesis, I took Catholicism, like, you know, I could tell you a lot about that. Probably not that much. I always found class, like, when I was a kid, I found that those classes to be a snooze, I'm not gonna lie. The spirit of Ramadan isn't talking about others. Exactly. Exactly. There you go.
And yet you're talking about others. You're the one who's supposedly Muslim. Everyone else isn't. That's talking about you. So, turn the other cheek. I know that's a Christian thing, but... Hey, Jesus was a big thing in your faith, Chantal. So why don't you try it?
Anyways. Oh, and Courtney, about Mr. Cardigan, I don't care. Like, he's a liar, he's just a glorified hater, and he's gonna relive something about the past, go for it. Another one who has no content unless he's beating on the same fat women on the internet, beating down the same women, or trying to like make documentaries on us. Like, please, people need to get off their high horses and stop being self-righteous. Like, it's just insane. Hey, Vegas doll. Really? Another clout chaser, exactly, Kirjo. Exactly. But people are hungry for drama, like super hungry for drama. That's all people want. Is to see others miserable.
And you're hungry all the time.
You know? Whatever, backwards, babe. I'm not saying anything mean about anybody, so I'm gonna block you, goodbye. Like, another virtue signaler. I'm allowed to defend myself in Islam and talk about certain things if I want to. Did I insult any of these people? Yeah, they're ignorant, and they look dumb when they say things that are not true. Islam is like Christianity. The only difference is Islam has Muhammad, peace be upon him. It's very similar, Buckle Bunny. I don't see it. You rang. I could not. I could do the not eating, but the not drinking. It is hard, yeah. In all honesty, we have all done things in our past. It doesn't define who we are now. Exactly. Exactly. Exactly, Ava. Every right to defend yourself. Yeah, I mean, I'm not doing it in a super hateful way, lowering myself to their level anymore, you know? No, Grandma. Don't get excited. That is true. Not very nice to bring up people's past and shame them for it. Exactly. So.
Exactly, Chantel. So why don't you shut the hell up?
Why do they react to people who are suffering from issues? That's disgusting. Because they're ableist and they think that they're funny. Like, they do it for money. Like, imagine doing something so immoral just to fatten your pockets. Like, do you know how much karma you're going to get returned to you? Like, people think, they see people like living the good life right now, and they think that, oh, they're just getting, you know, richer, they're just getting more prosperous. And it's like,
hold on. That is the Muslim faith. Believe in karma. Oh, Muslims are just as likely as Hindus to believe in the concept of karma, which is not inherent to Islam. And all of a sudden my brain is not working and I don't know what inherent means anymore. That's lovely. Lovely. Ah, so karma is not natural to the Islamic faith.
Yeah, that's all gonna come, that's all going to tumble down on you because of the way you earn your money, because of the way you live your life, 100%. You know? You're a chicken honeymoon. Imagine if we judged everyone by their past, we'd all hate each other. Exactly. Hi, Vanna. But that's a blatant lie. I wasn't praying in the wrong direction. That's mostly what I wanted to prove. I do have an app. How do you guys even know I have, before accusing me, if I don't have an app or not? How, like, you don't know anything. You don't know if
That one slipped out, didn't it?
Anything at all. Especially about the religion. You Google things to find out. Like, get a life. Please. Thank you. Yeah, thanks, Courtney. My CPAP? Yeah, no. I just have rosacea. Pretty bad. It's like it's
five times dry the filters.
No makeup. Yeah, exactly, teardrop. Like, you know, it's so ridiculous. And these are like adults. These are adults. Like, why don't you act your age? Grow up. Like, what are you doing with your time, with your life? It's so sad.
Why don't you grow up, 4-year-old? We're just having a good time. You're the one that's all bothered.
Exactly. That's all they know how to do is bully other people. Yeah. For entertainment. They think, oh, it's just fun. It's entertainment. No. Someone's religion is not entertainment. Somebody's weight or their body shape is not entertainment. Like, get a life. Like, are you perfect? Is your body shape perfect?
Get this through your fucking fat head. Your fat body. Your fat legs. Your fat feet. your fat face, your fat forehead. Get this through your fat body. That was an example. I'm just giving an example. We are not fat shaming you. We are heinous bitch shaming you.
Are you, you know, like, I don't know. It's just, hi, Kelly. You get eczema on your face? Oh, no. It is kind of dark, yeah. The curtains block out a lot of the sun. Does this youth have cause rosacea? I don't know, maybe. I've had it for so long. I need another sleep study. Hi, Shannon. I'm like, no, you know, I do not like reaction channels. Not helpful. And without even looking at them, that's why I do not. Yeah, yeah. These people, like, how are you going to judge how I look praying? That's so disgusting to make fun of somebody, like, in sujood position when you don't even have a camera and don't show yourself. Are you serious? Like, my mind is, like, blown. I can't. I don't know how YouTube platforms these people, but I continue every day to report them. Hopefully, inshallah, they will do something about it. And I'm honestly, like, so close to just getting on a plane and going to sue the crap out of you-know-who. Like, I'm serious, I'm done. I see all these you call them lawsuits, but no, there's a lot of online harassment and defamation and making fun of people.
Once again, untouchable. She's from Canada. You're from Canada. It'd be even worse for you in another country. It's not going to happen. You're not going to get what you want, and you stay mad.
Hussie could win a case against DC when she did way less than you know who, fake potato, does every single day for years. What do you think I would be awarded? Like, seriously, I'm like fed up. I want to shut her up for good. I'm not kidding. So
you won't be able to. I'm sorry.
So yeah, I don't know, but I'm seriously like this close to doing it.
So you paying $5,000 to get all those subs and getting your YouTube manager, your real one, they won't be able to. Sorry. I'm sure people tried to get rid of your ass a long time ago and you're still here, so it's not gonna happen.
Close to getting off of here and booking a flight. Yesterday I came home with a lemon can and hot chocolate and I thought, thank goodness I don't have all the food beliefs like you do, Kelly.
Please go to Canada, Chantel. Because it looks like you're the one that doesn't have the life. You rarely go out. You sit on that chair all day and you talk into a camera. Much like I do. But now that the weather's getting better, and it's not 115 degrees in the summer, I like to go out!
And that's the thing, these people are obese themselves, okay? And they don't show themselves. So of course they can say, oh, I had pineapple bologna for dinner. Of course people are going to believe that, right? Because they don't show themselves, you know? That, I don't care, people, whatever. Call me fat, whatever, I don't care. That says more about you than it does about me. It always will. That's whatever, you know? Teardrop. Yeah, no, it's okay. I have the money to do it. I can do it. Hi, Yusuf. Lawsuit bees. Howie is good. I mean, I don't want him running around. I don't like him, like, out and not knowing where he is, you know?
Another thing. Remember when BBJ got her new house? Her new home? With Amy Flowers? And you tried calling the police? And that didn't go so swell for you? What makes it gonna be what's gonna make it different this time, Chantal?
People are always like, why can't a bigger cage? This is literally the biggest cage I've ever seen. The biggest one. Like, look it up online if you want. There's, like, if you see them in person, like, online you can see it. No, this is the biggest one that we found at the store, so.
Well, why don't you order a bigger one? Because I know when you wanted to go to Torrid back in Canada, they still didn't have your size, so you had to order online.
Yeah, really thrill hole, right? The spy, yeah. Imagine living your life just to spite somebody. Like, what kind of life do you have? And you have the nerve to judge someone else who's actually living their own life and making their own content. Even if you think it's bad content, that's all your content is picking apart my bad content. How boring and mundane are you then, you know? Yeah, Julia's sleeping.
I'm having a great time. helps me, it helps bring me out of my shell, reacting to you.
Yeah, tear drop. She needs to be put in her place for sure. She's like criminal. She's disgusting. You know, like, and I saw a tweet like,
yeah, she is. She's a criminal genius. Ooh. Up top, FFG. Up top.
Of her like being like, we like attacking Americans, like we don't think of lawsuits right away. Yeah, well, your eight landlords did when they took you to court for your non-paid rent. They even bag us for sticking with you. Yeah, of course they're going to. They
once again smashing on other bitches. Lovely woman.
Try to take any support system I have away.
Lovely Muslim woman.
And then they have the nerve to say that anyone else is narcissistic. Like, I can't. Or this, like, complete, speaking of narc, have you heard about this, like, narc channel, like, going after Amber Lynn? She's, like, an older woman, like, trying to be DC media, and she just thinks she knows everything. She picks apart everything about Amber Lynn, like, everything. She goes after her weight loss doctor. She's insane. Like, these people are insane. You're the only narc here, okay? You abuse somebody on...
Showing you the Cuba direction live. Fuck FFG, fuck Yaba, fuck DC Media Girl, fuck Amber Lynn, fuck everyone. I thought this was going to be a video of you showing the proper direction for praying to Mecca. Ugh. I love a good bitch rant, but I'll save it for the professionals. Have a good day, Chantal.